PSP is easily my favourite handheld ever. It's powerful, easy to use, has many forward-thinking features, and it can emulate many past consoles and systems, especially true if you love playing PS1 games on the go. I sure do. Playing Gran Turismo 2 on the handheld is fantastic. But in today's video, I want to look at the latest version of an emulator called PPSSPP. This PSP emulator has been around for a while now, and I think it's time to see what you can expect should you choose to use it. As per usual, here's how I captured both platforms. On my real PSP, I used a PSP 2000 model with component cables running into the OSSC. On the PSP, I selected Progressive, which enables 480p video output. Afterwards, I upscaled the footage to 960p by use of the OSSC's line doubling mode. Of course, PSP games are displayed in a small window, so I manually had to stretch the footage to full screen since my TV has no zoom function. As for PPSSPP, here are the settings I used. For the most part, all games tested used the same settings across the board, although with a few games, I had to play around with some modes to get more playable results. I also want to mention that I went for high-ish end settings as I wanted to see how much we could enhance the base PSP experience. Now, let's get into it. Tekken 6 is first up. This is a fantastic fighting game for the PSP. In a not too distant past, I dismissed this game thinking Tekken 5 was better. Man, I'm an idiot. The game kicks ass! Anyway, despite the best attempts of the PSP capture, the game still looks good, sharp enough to appreciate the detail, and I can definitely see everything no problem. You can see a lot of dithering on the screen, mind you. What is this, the PSP or the PS1? Oh well, I'm still glad the PSP 2000 and newer models have video out in the first place. What about PPSSPP? Well, this is definitely a huge step forward, in some ways. The text and picture icons look smeary to my eyes. You can change all of this if it's not up to your liking. I found this though to be the best choice considering the 7x upscale I applied to all of the games I played. But once you start actually playing Tekken 6, the results speak for themselves. The game has quite literally transformed and looks outstanding. The detail on display is incredible, and details I once couldn't see or found hard to notice show up as clear as day. Not to mention, using my DualShock 3 controller is much better than the PSP controls. Although I did notice that 2D elements also got a smeary look and some textures don't look that great, but otherwise, this is a clear step up from native hardware. Okay, what about sound? Put on your best headphones or speakers or get your best phone and see if you can hear a difference.
Round 1. Fight! Ha, sit, top, top. Sit, top, top. Round 1. Fight!
I'll quickly mention Tekken Dark Resurrection since the results are basically the same. This is still a quality title that you need should you own a PSP. Everything I've said for Tekken 6 applies here. Have a look at some side-by-sides and sound samples and judge for yourself. Tomb Raider Legend also got a PSP port. This attempt to bring the PS2 game here was quite good. It's not perfect though. The game's frame rate seems to be a big problem. The title screen is choppy, the cutscenes are stuttery, and the gameplay always dips under 30 FPS.
Just because no one's ever caught one, doesn't mean they're not real.
That is very true, but perhaps they don't wish to be found. I've heard they're rather fierce.
Yeti only look fierce. They probably don't like being so cold all the time.
This is still very playable and looks good for what it is, but I feel most people will skip this port in favour of the other console versions. What about PPSSPP? Yes, the graphics are better as usual, but check out the frame rate. It's so smooth and looks far better than what was going on the PSP, don't you think? Even the cutscenes ran smoothly with no performance issues at all. This is really cool to see. I had to remind myself I was using PPSSPP and not the PlayStation 2. And despite the performance increase, the audio doesn't go out of sync either.
They probably don't like being so cold all the time. I shouldn't like it either.
You never have to be cold, my Lara, if you don't want to be.
The game also plays better since the DualShock 3 is the DualShock 2, but with less buttons, because obviously PSP port. Still, you can see the environmental detail takes a hit somewhat as the texture quality is pretty poor. It reminds me of an N64 game. Still, Lara herself looks very nice, as to be expected. Bottom line, this is far better on PPSSPP.
Ascending! Alistair, meet Tiwanak. She's a lovely pre-Incan civilization.
Let's check out Darkstalkers the Chaos Tower next. This is a compilation of Darkstalkers 1, 2 and 3. I love the Darkstalkers series, and having this package on the PSP is nothing short of awesome. Seeing it on real hardware here, you can see it's a bit blurry once upscaled, but it's pretty good looking, especially thanks to the great 2D graphics on show. As for PPSSPP, well, it definitely looks sharper and it's easier to see certain details. Not to mention, the 2D look is not spoiled by PPSSPP, which, considering the other games, this is good news. It's still a bit blurry, mind you, but PPSSPP does a good job overall, and I do recommend playing it, especially now that the game actually works on PPSSPP. It never used to for me, so this was a great surprise. Pursuit Force Extreme Justice was interesting to try and run. On the PSP, no sweat. It looks great, plays like a champ, and I really had a lot of fun revisiting this game. I used to play it all the time 12 or so years ago.
Ski inbound. It's probably a scout.
We're gonna feed you to the gators, pig.
On PPSSPP, things looked good. At first. Once I got into gameplay, oh, big problem. Looks like the game is missing some important aspects, such as being able to see.
Escape.
I went back to the settings and used OpenGL instead. Ah, now that's more like it. Too bad the game is playing slower than normal and sounds awful. Alright, let's try to use these speeder packs. Wow, now that is impressive. As you can see, some games may need a bit of tweaking to get running, but once it works, it really works. It's amazing how much you can see once the game is upscaled.
Turn you out,
pig. Excellent. Two down and two to go. Step on it.
I wish the frame rate also doubled like on Tomb Raider Legend, but oh well, this is still awesome.
I'm bringing the hurt now.
Gran Turismo on the PSP is a technical masterpiece. It runs at 60 FPS, it's definitely the best looking racing game on the system, and it really is just a sight to behold. No one thought a game like this would even work on PSP, and well, here it is. While not perfect, I really enjoyed playing this game, and I'm glad the gameplay is fun too. Anyway, while the PSP capture was no sweat, PPSSPP was a different story. The game looked jaw-dropping. It reminded me of Gran Turismo 4 on the PS2 upscaled, and that is no easy feat. The car details that were fuzzy on real hardware show up as clear as the sun on PPSSPP. too bad the frame rate doesn't lock to 60. It's always stuttering at certain points on the track, and it's really annoying because this game looks so good. I'm certain this can be fixed. I just haven't figured out how yet. If someone in the comments knows how to fix this, tell me, because I really want to play this on PPSSPP. The last game I'll take a detailed look at is BlazBlue. If you know Guilty Gear, then you'll be right at home here. This 2D fighting game is a joy to play and look at. The animations and special effects look nifty and sweet. To see this running on a PSP is just the best thing ever. Well, almost. Still, this is a great looking game. How does the game play on PPSSPP? The game works well for the most part. A lot of the text and background elements are blurred, and there's even some strange seams in the gameplay, almost as if the upscale breaks this element of the graphics. The game plays well for the most part, but certain effects and transitions can cause slowdown from time to time. So, it plays well enough, but still needs improvement. Also, I bet in the settings somewhere there's a way to make all 2D elements look cleaner and less blurry. Right, let's take a quick look at the last few PSP games I compared before I make a final conclusion. Well, the results are very interesting indeed. On the one hand, PPSSPP can drastically improve the graphical quality of PSP games thanks to heavy upscaling and use of software techniques such as anti-aliasing and some clever hacking features. You can even speed up PSP games that never ran great on real hardware. If you had a PSP 3D game that ran awfully, then this might be for you. Of course, PPSSPP is not perfect and you may have to tinker with settings before you get a playable experience. I also feel a lot of games that use 2D elements in their graphics don't seem to fare that well since many of these games looked blurry or smudged when upscaled. Still, PPSSPP is a great way to play PSP games and using a controller makes playing PSP games a little less painful at times. On the flip side though, playing PSP games on real hardware is still a feature that impresses me to this day. Thank you for giving us the video output port, Sony! Right folks, let me know your thoughts on PPSSPP and until my next video, I will see you soon.